just know it's not real. And if you had not seen that movie, it would not be in your brain at all. So it's all in your brain, not in real life. So it's going to be okay. Let's take a deep breath together. Deep breath in. Do that again. Deep breath in. Hold it. And out. One more time. Deep breath in. Hold it. And out. Keep breathing at your own pace. Don't forget to breathe. I'm just going to be brushing your face a little bit to calm you down. Okay. I have this nice brush right here. It's called 3D Sweeties. By Julian Glander. Julian, 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 Julian. called Hula Cuties. There's these little blobs that are hula hooping. It says whoosh, 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 whoosh. Clunk, clunk. The purple blob says, hey, what gives? You knocked over my hula hoop. Green blob says, sorry, oops. Please don't be mad at me. I'm really sorry. Purple blob says, oh, it's okay. I know you didn't mean to. Let's kiss. Formula, these doofuses keep kissing each other. My initiative to create a weaponized super molecule for the Pentagon is a failure. Then this little friend says, Professor, don't say that. They love each other. And isn't love the greatest weapon of all? Dr. Krapkin, I don't know what to say. Then don't say anything, Professor. Oh, Krapkin, it's you. It's always been. And the blobs just keep looping. And that's it. What I love about these little blobs is that I think they're supposed to be atoms in a nucleus. Because, like, you can see on this one, you've got, like, a proton and an electron. And that's a nucleus. Or no, electrons. I haven't been to school in a while. If you're still having trouble, what I'm going to do now is kind of a guided visualization, but more of a free visualization rather than me telling you what to think about specifically. So, something that really helps me sleep. Sorry, there's crinkly things below me. Crinkly, 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 crinkly. Something that helps me sleep when I seen something scary or can't put something scary out of my mind is I like to think about one of my happiest memories. I know that some people may or may not have very happy memories in your life, or maybe looking back to the past can be painful, but I encourage you to think of one time in your life that you felt happy or calm. Maybe it was with a teacher who was giving you words of encouragement or advice. Maybe it was on a vacation to one of your favorite spots. Think of something big, small, something in your life, no matter how far back or how recent, where you felt calm and happy. Once you have that thought, I want you to put yourself in that memory. What did it look like? From all sides. If it was in a restaurant, what color were the walls? If you can't remember the color or anything, just make something up that feels good. Who was with you, if anyone was there? Was it loud or was it quiet? Loud or quiet? was the weather like? Was it bright and sunny? Or was it dark and gloomy? Even dark and gloomy times can be happy. How did this memory make you feel? What about it makes it your happiest memory? Go through all the motions of it. Try and think of it sequentially. Visualize it from beginning to end. Now you can keep thinking of this memory as you drift off and just let my voice become background. If you're having trouble thinking of something, you can listen to me telling you one of my first, I'm going to adjust my feet because they're falling asleep. I also think this is a great time to show you my velvet pants. Bam. I bought them from my coworker's girlfriend. Thank you, Taylor, if you're watching this. So, my favorite memory that I like when I'm falling asleep is the day that I met my boyfriend, Brendan. I find it helpful to think about memories that you associate with people that you know and love now. Because, for example, if you have a memory of someone who is maybe recently deceased, it can be difficult to feel content and relaxed. Do what works for you and feels okay in your heart. My boyfriend and I are very happy, and I love him, so that's why I like thinking about this memory. We met at a karaoke bar and restaurant. We had already had mutual friends, so we knew of each other, but we had never met. And we followed each other on Twitter. And we'd always kind of flirted with each other. And one day I messaged him and said, we should hang out for real. I want to be friends. So, in this memory, I'm going to put myself there. I was in this karaoke bar. The walls, I think, were brown and pink. In some spots, there are pictures all over the place. I remember I was in a back corner table with all of my friends, and the karaoke was happening to my right. And I look out the window, and I see him coming with his friends. He was hanging out with his friends for a little bit. But eventually, he texted me asking where I was, and I told him, and he came back to our table, and we met for the first time, and we hugged. I remember telling him that he was a lot taller in person than I thought he would be, which I think is a very strange and funny thing, that we have these assumptions about height specifically without knowing someone or ever seeing them. I just thought he would be shorter. He's about 6'2", and I'm 5'3", so it was a big jump. And then we sat at the table. I think he was wearing a black shirt, and I was wearing we both had pink hair at this point. If you remember, this was right before my major I need to step away moment, when my hair was short and pink. Pink, 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 pink. His hair was the exact same length and color. relationship is we would always have our hair the same unintentionally. We shaved our heads at the same time. We dyed them pink at the same time. That's funny. So anyways, I just remember being there. He watched me sing karaoke. He sang Lips of an Angel with my friend Hope. And then we took pictures together in front of a bunch of trash cans. And that is how we met. That story is very pleasant for me. It makes me feel very warm. You have memories that make you feel that way too. So, if you're still awake, if you're trying to sleep, so as you drift off, think of these pleasant memories. Your brain wants to sleep, and it will let you. Okay. Leave a light on. There's nothing wrong with that. Hug a friend. Just let yourself drift. You